Good morning, friends. Normally, events like this should be celebrated not by speeches but by eating something. But I thought somebody must have said that food for thought, but thought cannot replace food. And therefore, I am extremely happy that those who provide the nutritional security, food security, helping people to rejuvenate themselves and create energy to the bodies of the people, all those are here, and therefore I wish to congratulate FICCI for bringing such a good lot of people together. In today's era, we are thinking about the huge obsolescence which will happen to a lot of sectors and industries. Technology is going to bring in a lot of redundancies. There will be so many sectors will not be there probably after some time. And even if they are there, they will be unrecognizable because of the changes that will be brought in by technology. People are talking about fourth industrial revolution. And what's going to happen after that? But one interesting thing is, one industry that will survive despite all this is the food industry. Because any revolution, maybe even 100th that may happen after 4th, 5th, 6th, maybe, then of course Bahubali may be there, I may not be there. But at that time, even then, people have to eat something. And therefore, food is obviously going to be surviving as an industry, irrespective of the changes that will happen in all of the sectors and all the segments. And therefore, we are in the process of drawing an industrial policy, new industrial policy, only third in independent India, and we are focusing on some sectors, and not only industrial policy alone, but even in my responsibility as a Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, we are trying to identify sectors which should be growing at a much faster rate than before. And clearly, in my opinion, food is one such sector. Because when you earn more, you want to eat not necessarily more quantity, but different kind of food. That creates a new segment of industry, health food. What it means, I don't know, but what it is. But that will be another segment. Those who have not been earning enough, the first thing that they do when they start earning more than their previous income, the incremental amount is spent on food. This is poor. So the food will constitute the highest amount in a family budget of a poor person, unfortunately. Because he wants to eat, obviously he has to survive, and that's the only thing he has got. His only capital is his body. Because he puts in labor, that gives him source of value. And to keep the body going, he has to eat. And therefore, the people at a poorest level will like to earn and eat more as the income level goes up. Those income level already gone up and they are earning enough. They have the luxury of going in for something which our good friends, many of you sitting here, would be producing health food. And therefore that again will be a demand for that. So one thing will always happen is, despite the fact that all other sectors of economy will keep undergoing a change, not only in India, globally, but it is one sector which will continue to grow. The nature of food that we eat will obviously change and has changed. For example, and I should not be saying this because my good old friend Mr. Bahubala used to be the secretary. So administrator, he has now become regulator. So he can regulate my speech. But he will tell you that over a period of time, our food habits in India itself has changed. We are producing more We don't produce as much agriculture as we produce horticulture. We produce more horticulture than agriculture. It's about 300 million tons of horticulture, or 270, 275 million tons of agriculture. So that means that people are already eating more than what they could never imagine they could eat. About 30, 40 years ago, somebody had told you that you can eat apple round a year. Because then there was a coinage that apple a day could only be for apple a month. It was not apple a day for all 365 days. But now you can do that. People are drinking milk more than ever. We are in fact in a position to export milk. And that's what we have done. That's a great evolution. But point is, the food habits have changed and will continue to change. People are now eating more of processed food because obviously now there is no more dispute, luckily, because of the processed food, that who should cook, the husband or wife. Now there is a settlement that has been made, now we have processed food, there is no issue at all. Nobody is speaking. So that's something which I must thank the processed food industry for settling matrimonial disputes. So no problem at all. And therefore, the processed food has again emerged as one of the large industries. And this is something which is good because you can ready to eat, something which can actually be properly regulated thanks to Mr. Bahubala, what goes into it. So sometimes you think processed food is not good, but with good regulation, it can be better. Because when you have fresh food, you don't know how it is, but here you can actually do it. So in fact, that's something which in my opinion is not a bad idea. And therefore, we must commend our regulator also for coming out with certain good guidelines over a period of time. It has evolved, and I'm sure it will get even better. So processed food is another big industry which has emerged. This is also creating an opportunity for manufacturing. Basically, the food is not necessarily manufactured unless it is processed. Because when you cook the food, it can at best go into the service sector. But when you process it, you put it, package it, market it, this gets into the manufacturing chain. And this has a very positive impact on downstream activities. Because more of the processed food is available, more will be the wastage of like 30% of food and vegetable that we lose. And we are, despite the fact that we are the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world. So probably we are the second largest, but not be the largest in terms of wastage. And therefore, this particular one, if it can be processed, we are avoiding the losses. We are helping the farmer to get a better income for that. And also what is processed will be available for those who are unfortunately not getting enough. So it addresses the nutritional security issue. So all of this is going to be a great opportunity. I will tell you a few things about what can be done as an export segment, because I have been responsible. VIPP is to manufacture, the other is to export. We are promoting exports from India in a big way. Only regularly, we have been having meetings with all my counterparts globally. We are preparing a strategy for $1 trillion of exports, which will of course include services. So merchandise and services put together, when we have $5 trillion of GDP, at least $1 trillion of exports should come from that, and we are preparing a complete detailed strategy, which markets, what products, what services, how can it go, what are the strategies domestically we must put in place to make it happen, all of that we are doing. But in that, amongst other sectors, food could be another very important thing. Because now, when we have large quantity of agriculture and horticulture coming in, we need to process it. After we processed it, we need not only cater to domestic market. It can be exported. In fact, my first day in office, I had announced, even before I went to the office, because as Mr. Bhogna knows that I have old interest in agriculture. Therefore, we had a very big event. It was pre-planned when I was railway minister. So I accepted as railway minister, so I had to attend that program. And I announced that we prepare an export, agriculture export strategy. Policy for agriculture export, which is a very advanced thing. So one is to export agriculture products. But there is no value addition. So if you can do value addition and export it, that's something which will create jobs in India, will create opportunities in India, and also will get better value for what you are selling. So that's something which we should focus on. Another element of that, and therefore for that, I have talked to yesterday only to my counterparts in UAE, because that's a big market. See, there are two kinds of food that you can export. One, where there is Indian population living all over the world, and there are almost 30 million people of Indian origin living all over the world. So they have a eating habits still not changed, despite the fact that some of them must have migrated years ago. In fact, I must say that the culture of those who migrated centuries ago have been more intact, more adulterated than the present one. So they have kept that eating habits intact, so they may be eating it. But the second segment, so we should try to cater to that. But second segment is, we should not only export food of what Indians like to eat there, but develop a food which other countries, what Japanese want to eat, which why not should produce it here and then export it. What Korean wants, we should export it. What Europeans like. So think about our vision should be not only export processed food because we like it in India and we try to find out the Indian population elsewhere, diaspora, and try to export it to them. That's one good segment, we should exploit it fully. But there are so many other markets where the local food that those people use, their staple food, if you can make it in India and export it, it will also be useful. So that's something we should also look at. The third segment is the marine products. There is a huge scope for export of marine products from India. And that again, I just had a meeting of IMPIDA in Goa, very big festival. I gave them a clear-cut target, preparing a strategy as to how we can export this. Again, that should be value-added. If we just sell it as we are selling it today, we are not getting enough money for it. So if you have a strategy clearly defined and well executed, how to do it? And if well executed, what has to be done by the industry? If you expect that government will make policy, government will export, and then you will also have the right of blaming the government, this good idea will happen, but nothing will happen. If the industry, everything has to be done by the government, I think I was just telling somebody that I was talking to a friend, he said, you know, our margins were earlier 7%, so that time we were giving us good subsidy. Now it has gone down, so you must give us more. I said, normally, when the daughter is married, the father-in-law says, I think the son-in-law needs some support, so he gives something. So after 2 years, again the son-in-law goes, say, now I have one more child, so please give me a little more money, because now I have to take care of bigger family. After some time, another few children and some more money. I think even father-in-law will not do like this to this. So please, if you expect only the government should do everything, it is never going to work. We must think that industry has to stand on their own. Government job is to give policy support. Government will help you to create infrastructure. But we must take those opportunities available rather than only coming to Udyog Bhavan or North Block or South Block and telling them. Or even agriculture ministry. So we must try to therefore prepare a good strategy, execute it. Tell us where you want the support. But we are preparing all this already. And therefore, there is a great opportunity. We have 7,600 kilometers of coastline. We almost 35, more than 35 agroclimatic zones. We produce all kinds of food. And I am really amazed by the ability of our farmers to produce. Kiwi was only said to be a fruit of New Zealand. Now, we can produce that in India. And that is what is our ability. So now, let's take the next step forward, convert that into food and try to export. So let me once again congratulate you. I think, as I said, the ideal way in future, Mr. Dilip Chinna, I think, will do that, is when you want to have a food program, you should be more eating and less talking. That's what you should try to do. That's what will really succeed in making it more beneficial, more outcome-oriented. Thank you very much.